Hi guys, here we are again. This is chapter 3 phlebotomy. We're actually going to talk about actually doing your venipunctures, and some of this would be very familiar from the study guide page that I sent you, to told you to read the first page, and it is in your messenger. So we'll go ahead. Methods of specimen collection. Of course, we know it has to be done properly to ensure accuracy. They should be seated in a chair. Sometimes they may be lying down, and you may have to describe in your notes where they were. Were they laying down? Were they sitting up? How were they laying down? A supine position means that they're laying face up on their back. Means they're just laying on their back looking up. And I always say supine. They're laying on their spine, looking up. Just the word itself, supine, up, laying on their spine. Then you got your prone position. They're laying on their stomach. Always help people remember with that. Prone to suffocate. If you're laying on your stomach, a lot of times you can get your face in the pillow and suffocate. So, but that is a position. When drawing blood from the back of a patient's hand, the prone position may also refer to the hand of the patient. So you also call that your prone for your hand as well. When collecting samples for glucose or cholesterol monitoring, they kind of put a lot of information right here in these first paragraphs. You have to tell them. They have to wait 12 hours, 8 to 12 hours. Most of the time, it's 12 hours. Glucose level is most commonly requested time specimen. You will see that. What is a time specimen? That means we need to do it at a specific time. And glucose is that. Normally, we'll do glucose testing. That should be a finger stick or a blood draw. It just depends on what the doctor orders, but it is normally timed in the morning, afternoon, even night for some people. Really depends. There are three general methods for specimen collection. You've got your venipuncture, capillary puncture, and arterial puncture. We will not be doing arterial punctures. Venipuncture is just the one from your arm or hand. Capillary, that's the one from your finger. And you can also now do those on your arm as well, on the forearm. And your arterial puncture. So venipuncture we'll talk about first. First, you have to have all your equipment. Of course, venia means veins. Puncture is puncturing your veins. We'll need the proper equipment. If blood is collected to determine the level of medications, the blood should be collected just before the next dose of medication. And they interject that there, meaning, and you need to underline all these things that I have here as well. Underline, if blood is collected to determine the level of medications, the blood should be collected just before the next dose. So say you're taking Tylenol, and that's usually it's seizure medicines. They do a lot of collecting to make sure that your seizure levels stay, or your meds for your seizures stay correct. But they're going to do it right before the next dose. Why right before? Because as your medicines are used, we'll call it that, the levels in your blood decrease over time. And by the next dose, you may have lowered the levels that you should be. Say, Dilantin. Dilantin is a seizure medication. It needs to be between 10 and 20. Right before your next dose, it may be lower. It may be 8. And we need to know that, so that's not keeping you within your level. And it needs to be 10 to 20. So the doctor will order you a dosage up on your medications just off of our blood draws. So this is very important. It needs to be taken on a drug level right before the next dose. You need your gloves, evacuated collection tubes. That is just a tube that collects the blood. You need your needles. Then you need the holder adapter, and that is just something that actually just keeps it in place so you can use the tube as you stick the person. syringes, your tourniquet, alcohol wipes, gauze sponges, bandages, your needle disposal. You need something to put those used needles in. If you don't have that, then you shouldn't even be doing the blood draw. You need something to immediately stick a person and put their used needles in a receptacle. And we call that our safety container. Then we have, and I want y'all to underline, the site selection. Best site selection is your medial cubital veins. Those are the ones most preferred. And it is located in the antecubital area. And all that is the area slightly below the elbow. And it's right there where we will be drawing blood from most of the time. Those are where your best and biggest veins are. And that's where we want to draw from. Arteries are mostly elastic and pulsate. So if you feel this vein, what you think is the vein, what you're about to stick, and you're just drawing blood, if it's pulsating, that is not what you stick. You find something else because that is an artery. We're not doing artery sticks. Artery sticks are done differently than a regular venipuncture. You want to check mostly for the superficial veins. Just feel, tap, massage. You can apply a warm cloth, doing something that makes blood flow to that area. And of course, we use a tourniquet. So the procedure, approach the patients in a friendly manner. Identify them. If you do not identify your patient, then don't stick them. They may be the wrong patient. They may have gotten the wrong bed. You can't just assume. You identify them in what ways you can. You should have a requisition form. They should be sitting most of the time in a chair or up in their bed. And sometimes you'll have to draw blood with people lying in the bed. And that's even easier, actually, because their arm is just stretched out and easily stretched out for you to find your veins. You apply the tourniquet, and that's a test question for sure, 3 to 4 inches above the selected puncture site. Make sure you ask them to make a fist. Prepare the patient's arm with alcohol prep. Clean it in a circular motion from the inside out. Alcohol should be allowed to dry 30 to 60 seconds. So your question would be, how long does it take alcohol to dry? 30 to 60 seconds. Needles should be from an angle of 15 to 30 degrees. So remember, 15 to 35 degrees with the bevel up. The bevel is actually the hole in the needle. It is actually in an angle. So you want that, you can actually see the whole hole of the needle. And they call that the bevel side. So you want the hole towards the top or up. Remove your tourniquet as you begin, the blood begins to flow.